Yes, amen. Praise the Lord. I'm Cadillac Kimberly, and this is According to Me, Cadillac Kimberly, vlog number 24. How are you? I've missed you. Do I look all right? Because my company just left, honey. He damn near put my head through the headboard. I loved it, okay? And, honey, I've been had a cold on top of my period. Woo, honey, I've been through it. It was rough and it was tough. I deserve some ding-a-ling for getting through it, okay? I felt bad. I felt about as bad as Candy looking sound when she's singing. Okay, and let's go ahead and keep talking about ass and talk about Real Housewives of Atlanta. We're going to start off in the A. That's where I stay. Okay, now everybody acting like they so shocked at how Candy is betraying Phaedra. I don't know why. Because when Phaedra had Aiden 6 years ago in Augusta, Candy drove down there to be by her side and act like she was such a close friend. Okay, and then came right back up here the same day and filmed with the rest of the cast and said that Phaedra had lied about her due date. So if y'all should have known then, Candy wasn't shit. I knew before then because she pulled some slick shit on me. But yeah, she a trip. She a two-faced asshole. And she deserved all the backlash she getting. Now, and she said last week that she loved money. Okay, she ain't lied about that because she loved it so much so that she risking her relationship with her child and her child's personal business for a damn storyline for the viewer. Okay, we don't have no business knowing that Block did not want Riley. Okay, that's some shit that should stay in the house. Candy done let the whole world know at the same time that Riley found out when a couple of episodes ago she started crying that ugly cry she always do and said that Block called her and told her that if she had the baby, he didn't want nothing to do with it. That means take your ass to the clinic, bitch. But if you don't go, don't be hounding me because I done told you I ain't want nothing to do with her ass. Okay, so why you acting like you so shocked 14 years later when he still don't fuck with the child? He told you at the gate he didn't want nothing to do with it, which means basically he also don't want shit to do with you, okay? Some shit you got to accept. But I just felt sorry for Riley, and I still feel sorry for her, because my children can be cruel. And to know some shit like that about you, that's just hard. And I heard that Block was married when Candy was fucking him. Is that true? I heard that the ex-wife that was the then wife when Candy was fucking Block, I heard she went on Hot 107.9 here in Atlanta and did an interview and said that she and Block were married when Candy was fucking him. I don't know if that's true or not, but if so, she needs to sit her ass down with that save stick she always shaking at some damn body. And don't Ace look like Riley? Don't they look alike to y'all? Wouldn't it be funny if Block was Ace's daddy too? Because, you know, Candy a hoe at heart, and she ain't happy that she giving it away, okay? And she ain't got no damn common sense. She got plenty of business sense. This ain't got no damn common sense. I don't even trust a bitch to cross a residential street. She dumb as hell, okay? She gonna say, I didn't say that Phaedra was cheating. I said she was dating. Bitch, if she married and she dating, that's cheating. You so fucking stupid, okay? I just don't understand. You ain't got enough sense to be embarrassed by your mama's behavior. I'm going to talk about Portia talking about, well, I guess she wearing that short hair so that when she in the alley and get into another fight, she don't have no hair to pull. Bitch, I know you ain't talking about nobody, but your stupid ass mama in the bridal shop acting like she going to throw her easy spirit shoe. If you don't sit your ass down, okay, and I think it's a damn shame that Tara's daughter had to tell you that it was best for you to go with Riley when she go with her daddy because they're supposed to be going somewhere to try to reconnect. You're going to just let her go with the man by herself. She don't even know that man, and you don't know the man. You ain't know him when you got pregnant by him. And you know, he could be a pedophile. No disrespect, Block, but I'm just saying, he could be a pedophile, he could be a pervert, he could be a freak. We don't even know. You don't even know, okay? Because half of the niggas you fuck, you don't know, okay? And you're gonna let your daughter go and be around him without you being there. Honey, please. That's because you got to keep your eye on Todd all the time. You got to babysit his ass and make sure he ain't spending your money and fucking your friends without you. Uh-huh. And speaking of fucking your friends, I believe you and that assistant Carmen got something going on. It's in my spirit. And y'all know Cadillac spirit be on point. It's something going on with that assistant and Candy. They know how each other tastes, I bet you. You know, what's her name? Carmen. The woman who got the cut in her face. Somebody done sliced her ass. Uh-huh. And did y'all see when everybody was at the consultation for Cynthia's boob job, how Candy looked like her mouth was watering looking at Cynthia's titties? I say, uh-huh. And I heard the food at the forthcoming restaurant, Old Lady Gang, I heard the shit nasty as hell, and I heard it tastes like the expired food that be in the refrigerator on hoarders. How about that? And what about Kenya fucking the children? And I had enough of her ass doing anything to get a storyline. Got her cousins jumping the gate looking like they're going to break in so she can pull her gun out. Bitch, please, you so fucking tired. And Carlos, I expect you to get rid of her ass next season because Kenya ain't bringing shit to the table. Okay? And we've also established that Portia is a liar. Okay? She said she didn't fuck Block. And I told y'all last vlog that she did fuck him. And it came out last episode that she did fuck him. Okay? So she lied about that. And also she lied about some shit that transpired between her and Candy, because when Candy went back and dug up them old text messages, it was proven that Portia was a lie again, okay? And Portia's mama, honey, she killed me looking like a knockoff Chaka Khan with them sausage arms like the women have on 600-pound life and my fat ass right behind her, baby. I tell you the truth. And what about Cynthia, honey, with that overpriced ass house? When she first said it was $1 million damn near, I said, where the hell are the $1 million at? I didn't see no day. I saw $600,000. So when they came back and said it was appraised for $600,000 instead of the $900,000, I could get with that. But Cynthia must be dumb as hell. She's going to pay almost $1 million for that damn house. And I tell you what, wouldn't it be funny if Noel and Peter was to get together? Okay, stranger things have happened. Okay, Trump getting ready to be the president. Stranger things have happened. Okay, when she told her mama on camera, when Noelle told Cynthia on camera that she had low self-esteem and that she could hear the shit she was putting up because they bedroom so close together, I like to fell out the damn bed. I said, Lord have mercy, in black houses, it's rule 101 that what go on in this house, stay in this house. That shit is damn near a rite of passage. I was like, what the fuck is Noelle doing? But I can tell you, Noelle is a pretty girl. She's very mature. She got a nice shape and she has excellent taste in music because she loves Bryson Tiller and I do too. And also, speaking of housewives, a former one, Nene, she might want to get her peach back, because I went to get waxed the other day and I passed by her clothing store and it was zero cars in the parking lot. So I guess the cashier gonna catch the bus home when she wake up. Mm-hmm. And let's talk about these hoes on Married Medicine. Well, one hoe in particular, Toya Bush. Okay, I got a problem with her. The bitch gonna report me to Twitter because I said on Twitter her husband is fat, spineless, and a broke bitch, and I believe it. Okay, and I was like, damn, she gonna call the police on me on Twitter, but yet she can talk about Lisa Nicole Cloud's husband all the time and call him gay. But when somebody come at her husband, she got something to say, like the way she came at me. I'm like Lisa Nicole Cloud, honey.
You don't run me, bitch. You don't.
Okay, and you so damn mean. Was you molested? Woo. Your husband better be careful because you so thirsty for money, honey. You'll have his ass killed. Eugene better be careful because you probably got an insurance policy on his ass he don't even know about. He probably worth more to you dead than he is alive. Eugene better be slow to eat all that shit that she feeding him with his fat ass. And I went to the doctor's office the other day and the cashier, but not the cashier, the receptionist. She said, Miss Freeman, do you watch Love and Hip Hop? I said, you mean Lies and Hip Hop? I said, no, I don't watch it. I'm afraid that watching it might lower my credit score. I don't fuck around with that shit. And she said, do you believe that Kirk got an outside baby? I told her, hell no, I don't believe Kirk got no outside baby. I don't believe he like pussy enough to have an inside baby. I don't believe the children he got with Rashida is his, okay? And with her being Candy's friend, she probably the biggest hoe in the cover that you ever seen. But yeah, I don't believe Kirk got no outside child, but y'all probably believe it like y'all believe that Yandy and Mendici was married. What y'all gonna do is be a fool for Mon Scott Young again the whole season, and in the season finale or at the reunion, she gonna tell y'all that Kirk is not the father, okay? But y'all so damn dumb, y'all believe man went to the moon, and y'all believe the damn cow jumped over it. You help somewhere. That's all I got to say about that. And, lastly, about Atlanta, I'm going to touch on TLC. I told y'all I'm behind. Well, did I tell y'all? Well, if not, you know, now I'm behind. I just now saw the Taraji Christmas special, okay? And I saw TLC on there. And I said, what the hell is going on with T-Bar? She was moving like she had arthritis, okay? And she got big as hell. And I was watching it in high depth. You can imagine the terror. And I mean, she was just acting like she didn't want to be there. She was moving like the check didn't clear. I said, what the hell wrong with her? And then chilling, honey, with them pre-K titties, she's still rocking and still wearing that baby hair pulled down. I said, Lord help, okay? But I think it's a good concept. I like the show. And Alicia Keys and Arja Day got down. But honey, I was introduced to Candace Boyd for the first time. I don't know where I've been because I hadn't heard of her. She's a bad motherfucker. I demand she get a Grammy right now. And I don't want to hear shit else about it. Oh my goodness. It was good. But I tell you what, the skits are lame. So Taraji and BT or Fox, y'all might want to holler at me for some material. And what about Mariah Carey fucking up the New Year's Eve song, y'all? Hold on. My beverage choice of tonight is that expensive-ass Elio Peron that I told you all about in my last vlog. And a lot of y'all been asking me about it. I'll tell you the information at the end of this vlog. Amen? Amen. But yeah, Mariah Carey, old Millie Vanilla ass, okay? If I was ever a patron at one of her concerts, I would demand my damn money back. She a bootleg artist, okay? I was like, what? And then the tracks wasn't nothing but the high notes. So the bitch can do everything but the high notes. Bitch, the high notes is what make you a diva. You don't see Aretha Franklin coming out to no damn track. I was like, what the hell? And she unprofessional as hell to be doing this as long as she been doing this. Bitch, Beyonce fell down, got right back up. We was like, did the bitch really fall? So hell got caught up in the fan when she was singing. She still didn't miss a beat. That's professionalism. That's a diva. Mariah, that's the level you need to get on, okay? And what about Serena Williams? I ain't surprised she said she married no white man, but I am surprised she said she gonna get married so soon, because she ain't been with his ass no time, has she? I think she just bored, okay? Because they ain't even been together long enough to come out the rubbers, have they? Mm-hmm. We'll see if they actually get married. If they do, I give it a year. Mm-hmm. And what about Kimberly? Is she homeless yet? Because if not, she soon will be. She done said that the homosexuals are perverse. I'm like, bitch, do you know that straight people are perverse too? I was like, what in the world? And all gay people aren't perverse. And I told y'all before, some gay people are here on assignment so scripture can be fulfilled. I was like, Lord have mercy. They canceled her from Ellen. They canceled her radio show. Pharrell talked against her on Twitter. I said, poor Kimberly, baby. I said, you know, she always bragging about how she friends with Whitney Houston, how tight they were. Well, how about your career finna be buried right next to her? Mm. And y'all, it's praying time. Honey, President-elect Donald Trump about to set it off on Friday. Woo, honey, I don't know how this motherfucker got in. But, you know, I always said that he manipulated the vote some type of way. And they saying he got cahoots with Russia and got it done. I don't know who he had cahoots with, but I believe he stole the election some kind of way. I believe he pulled some slick shit. I really do. And I don't trust his ass at all. I trust him about as much as I trust Candy at an all-girls school, okay? Somebody gonna get fucked. And that's just the way it is. Uh-huh. And what about him appointing his senior advisor as he appointed his son-in-law as senior advisor. Okay, that's nepotism on steroids, and the shit got me terrified. Okay, and Donald Trump has zero dignity, okay, but he is funny. The motherfucker funny as hell. He way funnier than Kevin Hart, okay, but funny is not what we need. You know, running this country ain't no joke, okay. His candor is refreshing, but it's inappropriate for the leader of the free world, okay. The way he get on Twitter and act, I was like, this man has no dignity, no class, no reverence. I was like, what the fuck is wrong with this man, okay? And you know, but you know what? He fooled us and won the presidency, so he might just fool us and get down as president, and it's my hope that he will. You know, but he ain't no damn Obama, and that's for damn sure. And Obama did everything I wanted him to do except paint the White House black. Okay? Black people was in it. Black people built it. I believe the damn White House should have been black when the Obamas were in there. And that's just how I damn feel. And y'all know Paula White is doing the prayer at the inauguration. And you know she was investigated for questionable fundraising practices. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Stealing! That's basically what it's saying. And is it me? Is it just me, or is Vice President-elect Pence a good-looking man? He good-looking to me. If he's 6'2", if he at least 6'2", baby, he can fuck up every blue dress I got, okay? And I didn't vote because wasn't nobody to vote for. And y'all can be like, oh my God, Cadillac, you didn't do your duty as a citizen. Fuck you, okay? Wasn't nobody to vote for, okay? I don't believe in Trump, and I don't believe in Hillary, okay? And not only do I not believe in Hillary, a woman is not to lead. And I told y'all that I don't know how many times. That's Bible. A woman is not to lead, okay? A woman should not have headship over a man, so she definitely shouldn't be leading the country. And yeah, there are at least 80 other countries that have women as leaders. I don't give a damn what the other countries doing. I don't live there, okay? I care about where I stay, right here in the A, okay? And I read in Hillary's book that she said she voted for the war and that she was in favor of late-term abortions, okay? What the hell kind of shit is that? I said, But I tell you what, as long as Trump don't fuck with my food stamps, we good. He better not fuck with that $194 a month. Fuck with that $194 a month and see what happened, okay? Kanye had a meeting. I'm going to need a meeting, okay? And I tell you who should be president, honey, Charlemagne the God. I love me some damn Charlemagne the God. Woo, honey, he everything to me. The Breakfast Club, I listen to them every morning. And if I'm at home, I watch them every morning. And I love the Breakfast Club. I love the synergy. You know, it's good. Like the type of stuff that Reggie Rouse puts together. You know, the Breakfast Club has a good program director like Reggie Rouse. You know, Reggie Rouse is the program director here in Atlanta. He's over B103. And I love me some damn Reggie Rouse. Oh, my God. You can't say shit about Reggie around me. I love me some Reggie Rouse. I've had a crush on him for years, and everybody who know me know that, okay? He's smart. He's intelligent. He's well-spoken. He's versatile. He's educated. He's powerful. I love me some damn Reggie Rouse. Love you, Reggie. Okay. Yeah, but I love Reggie. And you say some shit about him, and I slap the shit out of you at your church. Okay, I don't give a fuck when it comes to Reggie. I don't mess around. Okay, and what about the Kardashians, y'all? What about the Kardashians? Okay, I think Kanye should go on to Yonla. I would watch that shit on pay-per-view. Damn, Chris Brown and Soulja Boy fighting. I want to see Kanye on Yonla Fix My Life, okay? And Kim is the female in the marriage, but Kanye is the bitch, okay? And he is not going to be satisfied until he does everything that Jay-Z does. Because, you know, he wants to be Jay-Z so bad, but Jay-Z is up here. And Kanye is down here, okay? He'll never be a Kanye. And remember, Obama called Kanye a jackass. Remember when Obama first got in office, President Obama, he called Kanye a jackass. I don't think he recovered from that. But I'd be glad when Kim leave his ass, and it's going to happen. And when she does, he going to act like he attempting suicide to get the spotlight again, okay? He's such a diva. Okay, but ever since he lost his mama, we all know that he hadn't been the same. But I never understood why his mama tried to get plastic surgery done, but she didn't fix her mouth. She had that overbite and that gap. And a gap is okay, but not when you got that titty hanging in the middle. She had that titty hanging in the middle and still didn't get her mouth fixed first. I was like, damn, black people got their priorities fucked up. And speaking of mothers, I believe Kris Kardashian had Black China's account hacked. You know, when it was hacked a little bit while back, I believe her Instagram account was hacked by some of Kris's people. But, Black China ain't no dumb chick. She looked dumb, but she ain't dumb as she looked. You see when she sent her friend, her best friend on Instagram, direct messages saying that Rob was fat and lazy and she was going to marry him and stay married to him for a year so she could trademark the name. Kris ain't the only damn businesswoman in town. But if Black China is really smart, she'll get an insurance policy on Rob because with that diabetes and that weight, yeah, it's justified. So, that's what I think about that. And I'm going to close on this somber note, unfortunately. We're going to touch on Eddie Long. Okay, you know, he passed recently. And I told you in my last vlog that he was in the hospital. So that should have prepared you, okay? Everybody was like, Cadillac, why you say you thank God for Eddie Long in your last vlog? I'll tell you why I said it. Because no matter how he lived and what he did in his private life, he brought multitudes of people to Christ. So for that, we have to give him some type of recognition and some type of honor. But I don't believe he died from no AIDS, and I don't believe he died from no cancer. Okay, they reporting he died from cancer, but I don't believe that. Because he gonna outright lie and say that he was doing a vegan diet, which is the contributor for his weight loss. That was a lie. All he had to do was say he had cancer. So the motherfucker was dying. So he lied during life. And he lied during death. I'm like, damn Eddie Long, baby. Woo. But why lie about having cancer? Okay, you can encourage others through your testimony. He lived in scandal and died in scandal. Okay, but what I believe killed him was the truth. I believe the truth that he knew about what happened with those boys is what killed him. I believe he had condemnation, and I believe he didn't confess his sin to anybody. The Bible says confess your sin one to another. And the reason it says that is because if you don't confess your sin, then it's a secret between you and the enemy, and it'll have a stronghold over you. And you'll be in spiritual warfare like I believe he was in. And I believe that keeping the secret made the sickness, whatever it was, manifest into something else. The truth manifested into cancer, perhaps, but it stemmed from the truth, just like with Patsy Ramsey, JonBenet Ramsey's mother. I don't believe she died from cancer. I believe she know who killed her child, and keeping it on the inside and having to keep it hidden caused her to get an ailment. I believe that sicknesses can show up in your system in a different way, okay? And but you know, Eddie Long congregation is different anyway. You know, they the deceit over there is deep seated because it's a true story. I was dating a married judge that was on one of the auxiliaries over there, and we used to lay in the bed. He was married, and we used to lay in the bed and listen to Eddie Long. So you can see how the congregation is kind of twisted, you know? I was like, ugh. But, you know, it along emphatically and vehemently denied that he was gay and that he ever messed with the boys. But my thing is, if you're a leader and you have a legacy, why would you pay somebody out of court that slandered your name? I would fight you tooth and nail, because if he know the Bible says there comes a time to fight. Okay, that's the word. I don't understand that. I'll never understand it. But if he did, in fact, molest those boys, which I believe he did, I hope he got right with God. I really hope he got right with God, because that's a sad situation. And some people was waiting for me to make jokes or whatever, or to gloat about his death. I'm not going to do that, because death is sad no matter what. And I just hope he got right with God, and I hope he did confess his sin to somebody in that life. Because if not, I think it might become a problem on Judgment Day. You cannot repent from a situation if you don't admit your wrong. You can't. You just can't do it. Repentance is admitting your wrong and turning from it, not just stopping doing it. Okay, you can't just stop doing it. You got to repent from doing it. Okay, so if as much as he know the Bible, he ought to know that. I don't know, but I just tell the news, baby. And I want to give a shout out to my Clemson Tigers, my Green Bay Packers, and my Atlanta Falcons. All y'all are doing it. And in my next vlog, I'm going to address the question that I had in vlog number 21. I said, I need a lesbian to explain to me how come a female would get with a man that act like a woman instead of just getting with a man. Or was it, I asked that a woman, what did I ask? And I want to ask my lesbian followers. I love my lesbian followers. But let me ask y'all this. And please holler back at me. I think I'll post it on Facebook and we can have a discussion about it. But I want to know, if you're a lesbian and if you date a... Okay, let's say you're a feminine lesbian. And let's say you date a woman that's a butch lesbian, like Jay-Z's alleged mother. Okay, why would you get with a butch lesbian instead of just getting with a man? I don't understand why a lesbian would get with another woman that looks like a man instead of just getting a man. You know what I'm saying? So I hope I explained that well. And if you can, please enlighten me, because no lesbian has, butch or feminine or otherwise, has ever been able to answer that question for me. And I want to know. Please enlighten me so I can understand. Well, I got the answer. And I will let you know in the next vlog what I was told. And I believe every word that the lesbian told me. And also, this is a picture of the wine that everybody wants to know about. It's called Elio Peron. Here's a picture of it. You can see the spelling at the bottom. That's the answer to that. And what else do I have? That's pretty much all I have at this time. Let's see. You can follow me on Twitter at Caddy Kim. You can like my fan page on Facebook, Cadillac Kimberly's fan page. And you can Google me and you can YouTube me. And Corey Holcomb, call me. Y'all tell Corey Holcomb I'm trying to reach him, okay? I'm Cadillac Kimberly. Be blessed.
Hey, hello, hello, they know, hello.